Dear students, today we'll see what do we mean by a crystal oscillator. And here we are going to see the circuit of crystal oscillator using BJT, that is bijunction transistor or bipolar junction transistor. Okay? So here we have today's topic as a crystal oscillator using BJT. Now here, before going into the concepts of crystal oscillator, why we have landed over on this concept of a crystal oscillator is that why we have come to an option of a crystal oscillator, because in LC, that is the LC tank circuits oscillators, whatever we are seeing, or Hartley oscillator or Colpitts oscillator, and in RC type of oscillators, the major problem is that their operating frequency, okay, the operating frequency, that means the frequency of oscillations, does not remain strictly constant. This is a main problem, major problem of LC or RC oscillators, that their operating frequency does not remain strictly constant due to variations in a temperature, supply voltage, or also due to the factor of aging of components. Okay, now these factors are there always, and because of these factors, the operating frequency in LC and RC oscillators does not strictly remain constant. And because of this problem, okay, because to avoid this problem, and because in many of electronic applications, it is desirable to maintain the frequency constant. So because of this need, that in many applications, we want the frequency very much constant. Because of this need, we have to have a constant frequency of the oscillator. And therefore, piezoelectric crystals are used in place of LC or RC circuits. Oscillators of this type which use piezoelectric crystals are called as crystal oscillators. Such oscillators offer the most satisfactory method of stabilizing the frequency and are used in a great majority of electronic applications. So this is the background why we are going into the concept of crystal oscillator. Now here, the first statement, which is a basic statement, which gives on which principle the crystal oscillator works. So the principle of crystal oscillators depends upon the piezoelectric. So we can have piezoelectric crystals. There you can have crystals of quartz. You can have crystals of Rochelle salt, okay, which can give you the piezoelectric effect. Now, what does this effect means? Okay, now this effect is something which can convert mechanical energy to electrical energy, or electrical energy to mechanical energy. Inversely, if you see, it can convert a application of electrical voltage into mechanical vibrations, or it can convert mechanical vibrations into an electrical voltage. So this is your a principle of piezoelectric effect and the inverse of it. Then if you see exactly what it is, the piezoelectric effect, a crystal, whichever you use, whether it is a quartz crystal or a Rochelle salt crystal, okay, it will exhibit the property that when a mechanical stress is applied across one of the faces of the crystal, a potential difference is developed across the opposite faces of the crystal. Conversely, that is the inverse statement for that is, when a potential difference is applied across one of the faces, a mechanical stress is produced along the other face. This is known as piezoelectric effect and its inverse. Okay, now this effect we are going to use in our crystal oscillator. Now there are certain crystalline materials, like I have told you earlier, also Rochelle salt is there, quartz is there, a turbinal is there, which exhibit piezoelectric effect, and such materials are called as piezoelectric crystals. Quartz is the most commonly used piezoelectric crystal because it is inexpensive and readily available in the nature. So we are going to use a quartz or crystal here in our crystal oscillator. Now this is all a theory of what is piezoelectric effect and what is a crystal. Still, we have not entered into what is crystal oscillator. Now when a piezoelectric crystal is subjected, okay, when it is applied to a proper alternating potential, When an alternating voltage is applied to a crystal, it vibrates mechanically. The amplitude of mechanical vibrations become maximum. Remember this, the amplitude of mechanical vibrations become maximum when the frequency of alternating voltage which is applied is equal to the natural frequency of the crystal. So here you can see this circuit, you are applying a alternating quantity here. This is your alternating quantity AC, and here is your crystal, and here you can see two metal plates like a capacitor. In between them you are having a crystal. Okay, this is your crystal, which is your piezoelectric crystal, like for example quartz material. You can have quartz crystal. Okay, so now when a alternating quantity is applied to this crystal in this way, what we had seen is when a piezoelectric crystal is subjected to proper alternating potential, it vibrates mechanically. The amplitude of mechanical vibration becomes maximum when the frequency of the applied voltage, applied alternating voltage, is equal to the natural frequency of the crystal. This is a very important factor which we are going to use in our crystal oscillator. So then, working of a quartz crystal, as we have told you earlier that the quartz is the most commonly used piezoelectric crystal. So we have seen in the last circuit also that there are two metal plates like a capacitor, and in between them a quartz crystal is kept. So here, in order to make a crystal work in an electronic circuit, the crystal is placed between two metal plates in the form of a capacitor. Quartz is the most commonly used type of a crystal because of its availability and strong nature, while being inexpensive, that is less in cost. The AC voltage is applied in parallel to the crystal. This is a requirement. This is the feature of the quartz crystal. Now, if an AC voltage is applied to the crystal, it starts vibrating at the frequency of the applied voltage. This is very important to remember. When an AC voltage is applied to the crystal will start vibrating. That we'll call it as mechanical stress. It starts vibrating at the frequency of the applied voltage. However, if the frequency of the applied voltage is made equal to the natural frequency of the crystal, resonance takes place, and crystal vibrations reach a maximum value. This natural frequency is almost constant. This is the frequency what we are going to use. Okay, this frequency depends upon the resonance, whatever is taking place in the crystal. Now, if you see the equivalent circuit of a crystal, now here you are having a crystal, how it looks. So this is your crystal, this is a crystal, and these are your metal plates. These are metal plates just like a capacitor. You'll be having the two metal plates at the side of the crystal, and in between you are having a crystal. But what is the equivalent circuit of this crystal? The equivalent circuit of the crystal shows a resistance, a capacitance, and inductance, R, C, and L in series. This is your series combination. Okay, this is your series combination. And there is a capacitor CM, which is parallel to this combination. Okay. Now, when in the series or combination, whatever you see, this R and C and L, when the reactance of C, that is XC, and reactance of L, that is XL, becomes equal and opposite, they cancel out each other, and there is only resistance R remaining in the circuit. And at that time, the circuit is going to exhibit the property of series resonance. It is going to exhibit the property of series resonance. Similarly, when this R, C, and L reactance, when it is equal to the reactance of this capacitance, okay, that is XCM, then it will exhibit parallel resonance. Okay, that means this crystal is going to show you the performance of series resonance also and parallel resonance. So here we will see that theory. It is evident that the crystal has two closely spaced resonant frequencies. That is, it can operate in two resonance conditions. One is your series resonance condition, and the other one is your parallel resonance. Now, what happens in series resonance condition? The first point. The first one is the series resonance frequency, Fs, which occurs when the reactance of the inductance L is equal to the reactance of the capacitance C. In that case, the impedance of the equivalent circuit is equal to the resistance R, and the frequency of oscillation is given by the relation. Here you can see this is the frequency of oscillation. Fs is equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC. So if you write this in this way, Fs is equal to 1 upon 2 pi root LC. Okay. So here from that equivalent circuit, we are not taking CM. We are only speaking about L and C. Okay. So here the frequency of resonance for series resonance will be 1 by 2 pi root LC. Similarly, when we go to see the parallel resonant concept, point number 2, the second one is the parallel resonant frequency FP, which occurs when the reactance of the RLC branch, what we have seen in the equivalent circuit, is equal to the reactance of capacitor CM. At this frequency, the crystal offers a very high impedance to the external circuit, and the frequency of oscillation is given by the relation Fp is equal to 1 upon 2 pi root L Ct. Ct will be equivalent capacitance, which will be taken as C into Cm upon C plus Cm from your equivalent circuit. So we remember the equivalent circuit of the crystal like this. This will be C, this will be L. Okay, and here you are having Cm. Okay, so this was your equivalent circuit. So here this was R, C, L, and this was Cm. So taking C and Cm, this both, we are going to find out what is Ct. Okay, so here the resonant frequency for parallel resonance is given as Fp. Fp is equal to 1 upon 2 pi root LCT. Now, what is this CT? CT is nothing but it is the equivalent resistance of C and CM, and it is given as C into CM upon C plus CM. So, here you can see the expression for CT. Now, this is the resonant frequency if the parallel resonance of the crystal is exhibited. Then we'll go to the circuit, and this is the circuit where we will use series resonance concept. And this is the circuit which is going to show you what is or how does a crystal oscillator is built using BJT. Okay, so here we'll be having our transistor, that is BJT. So this is your BJT bijunction transistor. Now in this transistor, you have base here, you have emitter here, you have shown this arrow, you have a collector here. Now, to the base, you are applying the biasing resistors, that is voltage divided network, that is R1 and R2. That is when the VCC is applied, when this voltage plus VCC, that is the DC voltage is applied, the current is going to flow like this. It is going to flow like this. It is going to flow like this. It will build a voltage across R1. This will be your VR1, say. It will build a voltage across R2. This will be your VR2. And these voltages will see that the transistor operates in active region. That is the emitter base junction. This junction here is forward biased. And base collector junction, this junction here is reverse biased. Okay. And then we have this resistor RE and a capacitor C to see the stabilization of the circuit. And we have this radio frequency choke in the collector circuit so that it gives a very high impedance for the AC. Okay, so now here in this circuit we'll be having a feedback, the feedback from output. Okay, now this is the feedback from output to input. This is your feedback line, and in this feedback line you can see a capacitor and a crystal. This is your piezoelectric crystal. Okay, now the transistor and the feedback together will see that the phase shift in the circuit is around 360 degree, and therefore the feedback is going to be a positive feedback, and because of this positive feedback at the output here, you are going to have oscillations. Okay, And because the crystal here, the piezoelectric arc crystal, which is working on the piezoelectric effect, now this crystal, it is going to exhibit series resonance. So the frequency of resonance or the frequency of oscillations will be given as 1 by 2 pi root LC. Okay. So here the circuit will be somewhat same like your Hartley oscillator or a Colpitts oscillator. Only in this feedback network will be having a crystal. Okay. So here a crystal will be shown. Clear? In place of tank circuit or in place of LC circuit or RC circuits, you're going to have here crystals. Okay. Then we'll speak about the construction of this circuit, whatever we have seen now. In this circuit, the crystal is connected as a series element in the feedback path from a collector to base. This is what we have seen. That is, when your output is connected to input, there is a crystal. The resistors R1, R2, and RE provide a voltage divider stabilized DC bias circuit. The capacitor CE provides AC bypass of the emitter or resistor, and RFC, radio frequency check coil, provides DC bias while decoupling any AC signal on the power lines from affecting the output signal. The coupling capacitor C has a negligible impedance of the circuit operating frequency, but it blocks any DC between collector and base. So here we are speaking about the construction of the circuit. The circuit frequency of oscillation, as we have told you earlier, it is set by the series resonance frequency of the crystal, and it is given as Fs is equal to 1 upon 2 pi root LC. Then what are the advantages of this circuit? Number one, they have a high order of frequency stability. Number two, the quality factor Q of the crystal is very high. Number three, it has automatic amplitude control. Number four, it has very low frequency drift due to change in temperature and other parameters. Then if you go to see some of the main disadvantages, they are fragile and can be used in low power circuits. The frequency of oscillations cannot be changed appreciably. Then if you go to see some applications of a crystal oscillator, the crystal oscillators are used in the frequency synthesizers. It is used in special types of receivers. It is used in radio and TV transmitters. It is used as a crystal clock in microprocessors. So these are the few applications of crystal oscillators. Thank you, students.